Israeli apartheid. Is that going a little bit over the top? Is it really fair to say that Israel is an apartheid state? And to anybody who is thinking something like that, or to anybody who's got friends who ask questions along those lines, I would like to invite you to come along to a special forum that Friends of Palestine is hosting on the 29th of September. At that forum, the main guest speaker is going to be a person called Miko Peled. Miko Peled's grandfather was a person that signed the Israeli Declaration of Independence. Miko Peled's father was a soldier in the 1948 war, an Israeli soldier in the 1948 war, and an Israeli general in the 1967 war. This is a person who comes from a Zionist family. You can't get more Zionist than to have a grandfather who signed the Israeli Declaration of Independence. Now Miko Peled is speaking up for human rights in Palestine and Israel. He's speaking up for justice in human rights and in Israel and Palestine. And he's speaking up against Israeli apartheid. He will join the call. He supports the definition, the categorization that Israel is an apartheid state today. And if someone with Miko Peled from his background can recognize that Israel is an apartheid state, then I say that is good enough for us. So I'd like to encourage you all to come along to that forum because it will be a very interesting forum and it will be important. Now we're going to keep on continuing with our march. So I'll give you a new chant as well. Fight the power, turn the tide, end Israeli apartheid. Fight the power, turn the tide, end Israeli apartheid. Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Let's go, fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the power, turn the tide,
end Israeli apartheid.
Fight the free Palestine.
Occupation is a crime.
Got it. Apartheid has to fall. on the Armageddon, some odd friends of Israel, but we have a guest speaker coming in 2 weeks, Nico Peled. He is an Israeli-American. He was born in Jerusalem. His grandfather was a signatory to the Israeli Declaration of Human Rights. His father was a soldier in the 48 and a general in the 67 war. Nico Peled has lost a niece to a terrorist attack, a suicide bomb, so he's very well equipped to understand what's happening in Israel. And he is here to tell people that occupation is not only bad for Palestinians, it's not only a denial of basic human rights for Palestinians, it's bad for Israel. So if you're a friend of Israel, or if you're a friend of Palestine, I urge you to come along to hear about peace rather than occupation from an Israeli who knows what he's talking about. He's lived it, he's been there, and he knows that occupation is wrong for everyone. So please come along to UWA. We've got doors opening at 6 for a 6:30 start in the Fox Lecture Theatre on September the 29th, which is Thursday week. We'd really like to see you there. It's really important. Our next protest is going to be against Secret, who, as has been mentioned, are manufacturing products from stolen Dead Sea minerals. That's going to be at Carousel on the November the 12th, which is a Saturday. So have a look at our website for upcoming events. You can download Loud Flyers, both of those. We have people power on our side. We have justice on our side. So let's get the information out there and get people along so that they can learn what's going on in Israel and why the occupation is bad for Palestinians, it's bad for Israelis, it's bad for the world. See you there. Thank you all so much for coming, folks.
The message of justice for Palestine at that protest. October 28th, Chogham protest, and also just a final reminder, Nico Peled, 2 weeks' time, Thursday, 29th of September. Thanks everybody for coming here today.
See you in 2 weeks! Come and grab some tips from me!
Family. You can't get more Zionist than to have a grandfather who signed the
Declaration of Independence. Now we have the leader speaking up for human rights in Palestine and Israel. He's speaking up for justice in human rights in Israel and Palestine. And he's speaking